Okay, Bob Swanson here, ICC astronomy instructor, and wanted to make a little video to help you step through the Module 8 lab activity. This module is about, this activity is about sunspots, and it's a brand new activity, and so you should be on this screen. And one thing I can't stress enough, I do encourage you, and please do take the pretest. Like I said, this is a brand new activity, just written, and we need to do a little bit of assessment for it. So I'd like to know what you know about this topic coming in, and that's the way we can tell is that it's just a five question pretest. Doesn't help your grade, doesn't hurt your grade, can't help you or hurt you, but it does give us a baseline to know what you know about this topic coming in. Once you've done the pretest, then go ahead and do the lab activity. There's a student guide for you to print out. My suggestion is to go through the student guide and the lab quiz at the same time. Perhaps have them open up in different windows or browsers so you can go through them at the same time. But anyway, I'm going to step you through the student guide. So once you click on here, it's a Word document that should open up on your computer. And it looks like this. And so as you're going through it, there's a little bit of background material about sunspots. And then in part one, you are going to be plotting the sunspot cycle. And so there's a link for us to click. And so I can just control and click this. And it's going to open up the file. And you're going to see a file that looks like this. And this this file has the year of the sunspot observation, the month, as well as the number of sunspots in that particular month. The last column is not important for our purposes. So really, you're just going to focus on the first three columns of this file. And as the lab activity prompts you, it says before going any further, you need to answer question one in the lab quiz. So that's why I encourage you to have the lab quiz open at the same time as you have the lab activity open, because you're going to be doing them sort of hand in hand. Okay, once you've answered question number one, you're ready to move on. So you go back to your file, and the instructions tell you to select all the data. The way you can do that, at least on a PC, is by hitting Control A. So that's one thing I'm hoping, not only will you learn about sunspots, but you'll also learn some functionality on the computer by doing this activity. But Control-A will select all that data. Now we need to copy that to our clipboard, so you do Control-C. Again, instructions for a Mac might be different, but this is for a PC. So now I've got the information copied to my clipboard. I go back to the lab activity, and it tells me what to do. I need to now open up the application Notepad. And you can do this different ways. I know Windows 8 is a little more complex as far as finding Notepad, but for me, all I have to do is go down and click my Start button and find Notepad, start that up. And what I'm going to do is now I'm going to paste all that information that I just copied by doing a Control V. That puts all that information from that website into my Notepad. And that's what it's telling. Again, your instructions tell you how to do all this, but I'm just going to step through this as well for you. So once it's pasted, we're going to save this document. So I go back to Notepad. I'm going to save this thing, and it really doesn't matter what you call it. I recommend a certain file name, but really you can call it whatever you want. Just do Save As, and in this case, I'll save it to my desktop, if I can find my desktop, and save it as spot_num. And it's very important that we do save this as a text file, so we make sure that you have it chosen as a .txt file. And we say save. Once you've done that, you'll need to now have a graphing program. The one that I'm most familiar with is Excel, because it's a Microsoft product. So I'm going to open the file I just saved using Excel. And so I go down here, and sure enough, Excel is in my Start menu, so I click on Excel. And now I'm going to go to File and Open. And I have to go find the file that I just saved. Remember, it was on my desktop. And it's called... Now, one thing, it's not an Excel file, so you might have to actually choose All Files in order to be able to find your particular .txt file. So mine was called SpotNum, and sure enough, there it is. And so I click on it. I say Open. And immediately, it's going to give me a little menu that pops up, because it's not used to seeing this kind of a file, and that's what my instructions tell you. says Excel is not used to dealing with these TXT files, you have to tell it how to deal with this incoming data. And so what you do is you're going to choose fixed width. You're going to tell it that your data has headers, and then it's going to divide your data into a couple of different columns. So we're going to click next, and notice that it does divide the data into columns. Now we want to remove the divider between the year and the month. We want the year and the month to be imported together. So in order to do that, we double click. That gets rid of that line. And it turns out we don't want this last column of data. So we're going, once I've gotten the one divider out of the way, I hit next again. And now this is going to allow me to get rid of a column, as well as to tell it what format my year and month are in. So with this one highlighted, I click date, and I say I want it to be year, month, day. Now notice there are no days, but it doesn't matter. As long as my year is first and my month is second, that's the choice that I want to make. Notice also I want to skip this one, so I'm going to choose my last column, which says DEV at the top, and I want to say do not import. And once all that's done, I'm ready to click finish, and it's going to import my data into Excel with two columns, column A being year and month, and column B being the number of sunspots. And again, this is all this is detailed in the instructions, and that gets you this far. Now, once you have that data in there, we can select all the data. So I'm going to hit again Control A to select all the data, and now I want to insert a chart. And so in here you're going to see a bunch of different choices for charts. My suggestion is to do a line chart. You can try different types of charts, but for me, I'll do a line chart. And I'm just going to do a 2D line. Let me just do this one right here. And sure enough, I wind up with a chart that has my dates along the bottom and the number of sunspots on the y-axis. So number of sunspots on the y-axis, number of dates, the dates on the x-axis. And that pretty much gets you through part one of the instructions, and therefore you can then answer question two on your lab quiz. Okay, that's it for this video. We'll pick this up on the part two in our next video.